Alrighty, welcome to another Vintage Cube Draft here on ChannelFireball.com. I'm going to resist taking the pick one brain freeze. I think that is not the winningest strategy. And how many times can I force Bad Storm? Well, the answer is as many as I want. But I think I'm going to be starting off with here Emrakul to Aeon's Turn. So Emrakul combines with Sneak Attack at best, also Through the Breach, also Shallow Grave or Corpse Dance if you have ways to discard it. That's not too bad, and Emrakul is the most powerful Annihilator to put in, so I like starting with Emrakul. Gives you a good direction here. Ooh, there's some cards here. Upheaval, Dak, Simic Signet are all pretty legit. A Demonic Tutor also. This is a powerful pack. My inclination is to take Dak. Upheaval's also really good. The problem is if you don't end up with a lot of good mana, Upheaval isn't very good, whereas Dak's just good no matter what. I think they're both better than Simic Signet. As much as I like Demonic Tutor, I actually think Dak is just generally better. All right, well, I don't like Eureka. I think Eureka is pretty bad, and no one in the history of Cube has ever won a match casting Eurekas. But I will take Steam Vents. Red, blue to go with Dak, to go with Emrakul. I think we're in good shape there. Steam Vents over, yeah, Mana Confluence, I guess, be the next best. There's a Raphelos. Doesn't go with my first three picks, unfortunately. There's Dark Ritual, but I don't think I'm heading that direction. Or Strip Mine, but, you know, unless you get Crucible, I don't like Strip Mine very much. I do think, I mean, it's worth playing in most decks, but I think I might just take Charticorus. This puts me well on my way to having Emrakul and Shallow Grave or something along those lines. Ooh, there's Wildfire and Ready. I like both of those, and here's the Crucible. But I think I'm just going to take Preordain. Preordain is just a great card, and having access to it makes all of your decks more consistent. I like Oracle of Moldiah as well, but I love me a Preordain. Alright, well, Bribery is the clear winner here. As much as I think that the cube's better off without a card like Bribery in it, I think this card's kind of unfun. I think Bribery is an easy pick up here. Six pick Bribery is also a pretty good sign. Green's really open, by the way. Whoever's drafting mono green is getting paid off. Here I could take Nahiri. Nahiri is good with Emrakul, and I've been just impressed with Nahiri in general. She just snipes a lot of different things, so I think we're going to take Nahiri over Wasteland here. Same reason as Strip Mine, unless you have something like a Crucible or a specific land destruction theme, I don't really like taking that all that much. I'll take Wandering Fumarole, though. Big fan of that. Thing in the Ice has been a little too hard to get going for my tastes. Brain Freeze Wield. People are getting smart. I could take it here. I don't think it's unreasonable. I mean, I'm not going to play Raging Ravine, and I don't think I'm going to play Memory Jar. Sure, I'll take the Brain Freeze. There's an off chance that all the rituals wheel, and then I convince myself that Storm is open, and then I draft Storm, and then I go 0-1, and then people get mad, and then I draft again. Yeah, that all sounds fine. Well, there's the Cabal ritual, but honestly, I should just take Arcane Artisan. I'm looking to draft Sneak already, and as much as this card's been a little slow and vulnerable, I think it's better than a random speculative ritual. I will take Mana Confluence, though. I love having access to good lands. Oh, wow, Dark Ritual too. I'm just going to take Trinket Mage. I'm off the Ritual plan, and I'll take Trinket Mage in case I pick up some Artifact Mana. All right, I'll take Wildfire. I've been pretty happy with the Dak over Upheaval picks so far, given that I haven't picked up a single piece of Artifact Mana. And, you know, even Wildfire, for example, is not looking too good. This Emrakul is just kind of chilling there, but I think that there's a good chance we get Emrakul enablers. Like, we got a really late Arcane Artisan. Didn't pass any other big Eldrazi. I think if, you know, someone two or three seats to our left open Sneak Attack, we have outs. And, no pieces of power. There's Brainstorm, but I have nothing that combos with Brainstorm right now. Actually, not a single thing. Besides, I guess, the ultimate of Nahiri. There's Everflowing Chalice, which is a fine card. And there's Daze, which I actually have been more impressed with Daze the more I've played it. But I think I might just take Everflowing Chalice. This deck is going to eventually want some... Here, I'm going to start moving over here. This deck is eventually going to want some kind of ramp. Chalice does fit the bill, and I think that it's going to perform a little bit better than Brainstormer Daze here. I don't mind PNLR either. Ugin's a little expensive for my tastes here. This is pretty uninspiring. I mean, there's Mystical Tutor, but I'm not really that impressed with that. I'm going to take Tundra. Tundra helps me cast Nahiri already, so I'm looking to splash. It's better than Needle Spires. I'd rather just have it untapped and fetchable. If this was a Signet that was more on color than that, if it was any blue Signet, I would be taking it, but unfortunately does not. Woof, that's a late Library of Alexandria. All right, I should probably just take Library. I mean, Boros Signet's tempting also, because Boros Signet, again, helps splash Nahiri and is a Signet. But if you just have Library in your opening hand, you often just win those games. So let's just take Library. There's also a Marsh Flats that I guess I wouldn't have minded. And now we can take Seachrome Coast, but given that we have Tundra and Mana Confluence, I'm not as excited. And I just, the tap lands, I don't know, they can really, really cost you. There's Woodfall Primus, which is interesting. If I pick up Through the Breach or Sneak Attack, I'll want that. And then there's Faithless Looting, but I guess with Preordain, Charter Course, Dak, Nahiri, I'm feeling like I'm pretty good on that front. There's also a Braid and Dismember, but I just don't value straight up creature removal all that much. I'm just actually going to take the Woodfall Primus. I really want to get this sneak thing going. Okay, Flooded Strand is excellent. Flooded Strand's a tri-land. It gets Steam Vents or Tundra, which is nice. And, I mean, it's not, there's not even a good second. I guess it's second. Whoa. That's aggressive. I guess it's second is Spellseeker, but I'd rather just take Flooded Strand. My calendar's telling me to do things, but I'm just going to cube instead. I'll probably just take Ponder here. I do like Riftwing, but Ponder after I just picked up a fetch land is kind of nice. And, I mean, I guess there's also Monastery Mentor. I just like Ponder. I'm going to find a way to enable my powerful things. Don't you worry. All right, well, there's a V-click. I do like Dig Through Time when I have Ponder, Preordain, Charter Course. Oh, Dak. Yeah, maybe I should just take Dig Through Time. Like, if I do eventually get a way to combo something, then Dig Through Time will help. All right, I like Venser too. Venser is just a decent value card. A little better than Dragon Lord of Tarka or Siege Gang or Electromancer. I mean, Electromancer's not super far away, but I don't think I need it. Wow, Brainstorm and Daze both wield. I'll take the Brainstorm now. People are finally getting the message that Brainstorm's not great, but given that I have Flooded Strand... Oh, and I also have Trinket Mage that can get Chalice, and I'd hope to pick up something else to go get with that. All right, I'll take Needle Spires too. All right, I mean, this deck is missing a Sneak Attack or a Through the Breach. It needs those things badly, but it's got a lot of good support. With Preordain, Ponder, Brainstorm, Charter Course, Dig Through Time, I feel like I'm going to be reliable at picking those things up. I don't think I can mind Zare. Pretty unimpressed with Tamiyo. I might take Soulfire Grandmaster in case that somehow mines a Time Walk. And here I think I take Faithless Looting, especially now that I picked up Dig Through Time, and my mana's looking great, so I don't need the Seachrome Coast all that much. Well, blue and red are open. Like, I'm getting late Brainstorms and Faithless Lootings, you know, lands. It's more, are the specific cards I need gonna show up? Wildfire is also a distinct possibility if I end up with more artifact mana, though at this point, I'm not holding my breath. Jeez, no one's drafting green, I guess. I'll take the Savannah just in case, maybe pick up an Ancient Grudge or something. All right, this is actually a pick, which is interesting. I think I'll take Expansion Explosion. Oh, Wear Tear is a decent card, too. When you're playing straight-up Jeskai, I don't mind having Wear Tear in my deck. Expansion has a lot of things to target here. I can copy all my cheap 1 and 2 mana plays, and then I can also just play it for more mana. Oh, there's the Time Walk. Okay, Soulfire Grandmaster back in. Now we've got a plan. Sorry, Kiki. As much as I like Kiki, Metamorph, actually, I'm kind of a fan of Metamorphos, Dynamo. All these cards are nice, but Time Walk's the best card, and it even combos nicely with our Soulfire Grandmaster. Pretty easy Remand here. I don't need Wooded Foothills. My mana is just looking really good. And as much as I love Wooded Foothills, Remand is great. I just like having a little bit of interaction. I'm still on Sneak over basically anything, if it comes to that. Oh, well, there's a Kiki and a Twin, but not where we're at. Torrential Gearhulk can cast Remand nicely, or just Brainstorm? I guess Wear Tear. I guess Dig Through Time. those are things. I could just take Rakdos Signet. A second Signet isn't bad. I mean, I don't think I'm supposed to take Blightsteel, because at this point I already have two giant bricks that aren't doing anything anyway, so I'll just take a second Signet, and maybe if I'm lucky I'll pick up a Teferi or Jace or, you know, a 4 or 5 mana Planeswalker that the Signet can help with. I might actually just be in Inferno Titan territory where I'm just not playing Emrakul or Woodfall Primus and just playing Inferno Titan as something to ramp into in my blue-red control deck. Yeah, I mean, I think that's going to be a little better than Sower of Temptation here. I even just picked up a Signet. Here, if I can pick up a sneak attack or even a through the breach, I think this deck will be very good. If I don't, I think it's just going to be solid. I could use a little... Basically, when you're this controlling, you want a little more disruption. I guess I have an Arcane Artisan, kind of counts. But right now, I just have Remand. And all this digging is less good if I'm just, you know, I don't have that many spells that do anything. So I'm really looking for a big finisher here. I have four more picks. It's not inconceivable that I would get one of those cards, especially through the breach, since very few people tend to want that. It's not likely at this point, though. And by that, I mean, here's a through the breach. All right, easy through the breach. I mean, I'll keep the Titan in, but we're getting the Emrakul and the Woodfall Primus back in, passing up on a Thirst for Knowledge. Yeah, easiest pass on Thirst I've ever had. Wow, it actually might be that it's worth it to take Treasure Cruise, over, even though I have Dig Through Time, because I have between Faithless Looting, Chart a Course, DAC, Ponder, Brainstorm, Fetchland. I can fill up my graveyard pretty nicely. I should still just take Fire Ice, though. Fire Ice is awesome. Oh, I love Fracture Identity. That card's really strong. All right, I've been really impressed with it. So I'm going to take that over Young Peasy. And then I guess I'll take a Foff this late, sure. I mean, I could take Swords to Plowshares, but nah, Foff is awesome. All right, we're going to get Trinket Mage out of here. Probably going to get Arcane Artisan out of here. I just don't like the Artisan all that much. Expansion Explosion is borderline. I'm watching you, Expansion Explosion. Jace, Architect of Thought, or Banishing Light. I'm not in love with Banishing Light in general. I like Jace. All right, I'll take Expansion Explosion out because it's just... I think it's worse than my other options at 4 mana like Foff or Jace. And at 5 mana, these are all more powerful. I guess I'll take Sun Titan out. Or say take Sun Titan, even though I'm not going to play Sun Titan here. Oh, also with Time Walk, I failed to mention, Jace gets a lot better once you have Time Walk. All Planeswalkers are just better once you have Time Walk. So now I need to cut one card. It might just end up being the Wear Terror, because I do have Woodfall Primus to blow things up with. I could go 16 land with Looting, Brainstorm, Ponder, Preordain. That's not insane either. Well, I'm not high-tiding. I guess I'll take Torrential Gearhulk. I think that there's a world where Torrential Gearhulk was my finisher, but picking up that Through the Breach went a long way. I'll take Sower, and that's a good sideboard card at least. I can splash Tristani Discordant if I play against Mono Red, technically. I think I'd rather just take the red spell over Journey. They're actually kind of close, and both are sideboard cards. All right. The question is, do I play 16 land here? I kind of want to just play 17. I have a lot of ways. Whoa, there we go. I have a lot of ways to use my mana, including both Fumeral and Needle Spires. And then Library of Alexandria is also pretty nice. And I have all this ways to filter. I just don't think I'm going to get flooded that often. So the question is, what is my weakest card here? Is it just... Maybe it's just Wear Terror. I'll slide it in if I need it. But I have Nahiri. Oh, yeah. I have DAC and Nahiri and Fracture Identity and Woodfall Primus. So I'm actually covered. Okay. I assume my mana is great. Let's see. Ignore Woodfall Primus. I have just three white cards. And I have a Rakdos Signet. So right now I've got Library, Tundra, Steam Vents. All right. These two provide any color, so I don't want any forests. Thank you very much. So white, I have 1, 2, 3, 4 white sources without doing anything. I guess I could just put a Plains in for a fifth white source. Why not? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 blue sources plus 5 is 10 is not bad. And 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 red. 9 red. So in that case, I should probably just play another island. And we are set. Alrighty, welcome to round one. Oh, I'm going to keep this hand. This is the kind of hand that really makes Ponder valuable. Like, I've got some good mana, a little bit of early interaction. I'm just going to play Fumeral on one. Mana Acceleration in Everflowing Chalice, and then Ponder plus a fetch land means I can shuffle and find something good. Well, I'm going to lose to Mana Crypt, probably. Well, we'll see. We'll see. I might get to fire two things here. If they can play another Mana Dork, then... Okay. Well, sure. If they're going to Ancestral Recall plus Regrowth, we're a little outmatched here. All right, well, I mean, I'm just going to still fire the Lotus Cobra because with an Ancestral, I really don't want them to have access to tons of mana. Also, I have drawn a pair of lands here, which isn't exactly what I was hoping to pick up. Yeah, Ancestral Recall is pretty strong. So is Mana Crypt. So is the two combined. So are the two combined. Let's see what my opponent is looking to do here. They're gonna Ancestral, and then they're gonna play a Kadama's Reach. So they're up on cards and mana by a lot. They have six mana. Oh, they had to discard though? Nice. Let's just go Ponder and see what we see. There's Through the Breach. So I actually think... I think I just want to draw both of these. And I think... it's kind of awkward where if I remand, I draw the looting, but then I draw the land for my turn. But there's no way to shuffle. I think looting is still worth keeping. So I'm just going to play this and pass. Leave remand up. And then try to find... use looting to find Emrakul. Because Through the Breach can actually just get my opponent, even if they're up on tons of stuff. Like, Emrakul's just lethal now. Wickerbow Elder. Yeah, I will remand that. Actually, you know what? I will not. I don't care if they even... see that I have a remand. And Edric. That's kind of annoying. Now I kind of wish I remanded the other one. Alright, I'm going to remand Edric. Draw. I think I just go Faithless Looting here. I have not. I have not drawn well this game. Alright, I'm just going to play another Looting. And now I'll discard Chalice and... I guess just library. I'm not even close to using that. So, if I peel Emrakul, obviously, I'm in pretty good shape, assuming they don't have a counterspell, which their deck doesn't look super likely to have, but who knows. And then, if I draw Woodfall Primus, it's still decent. Alright. Need... Emrakul stat. Any Emrakuls. That's not an Emrakul. I'm at 17. I'm not dead next turn. I guess I can't do both of these things, both Jace and Chart a Course in the same turn. So let's just go Jace minus. It's like a little bit telling here, but I'll take Emmy. And 17, I'm going to take 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10, 11. So basically, I think it's worth shuffling the Braidstorm and Preordain back into my deck, even though it's not a huge deal. Well, they have a Lumbering Falls also. So at best, they can hit me for... oh, yeah, millions. Okay, so I had to have Emrakul a turn before. Well, my opponent's deck looks very good. But... I do have some outs here. Alright, I do think I want Sower and I want Mortars. And... well, maybe I don't want Mortars. I don't know. Mortars is kind of expensive. I guess it's just 2 mana, but... just like Mortarsing an elf is just not that impressive. I think Bribery is going to be good. Jace is going to be good. I guess Sower is also kind of expensive. I could play around Woodfall or... Wickerbow Elder by taking out Chalice and Rakdos Signet. But I think that those are still going to be fine. I don't really... on the draw, I'm happy taking out a land. On the play, I don't think I'm supposed to. I kind of feel like my deck is already pretty well set up for all this. Yeah, I think we're just going to battle here. I would like to play first. Alright, I'll keep this hand. This hand needs a Through the Breach pretty badly. It does get to... use Chalice to play it earlier. If I can draw a piece of action, well, that actually counts. So let's cast this for 1. And now I have turn 3 Foff into maybe a turn 4 Through the Breach. And if they don't have... are they Mox Ruby also? Dear Lord. Okay, I mean, if you have it all, you have it all, I guess. If they play something I can fire... oh, yeah, we're running that for sure. Oh, then we're going to Bribery next turn. Yoink. Alright, let's fire those two. Pick up my nice little 2-for-1. Fire Ice is so good. And then I'm just going to slam bribery here. I'll keep my fetch for later. I haven't seen any counter spells, and Crater Hoof Behemoth decks don't tend to have tons of counter spells anyway. Never mind, there's a Mystic Snake. Alright, sure. I guess I don't get a free win. Corsair Revealing Devoted Druid. Alright. Rakdos Signet. Okay, let's play the Signet. Play Flooded Strand and pass. Since they had blue up, so they could have had a counter spell anyway. Devoted Druid is fine. And I guess I'll just take it and Foff end of turn. I think I can afford to not crack Strand yet. I'll take an extra damage off of Mana Confluence here. Okay, so what does Through the Breach do? It kills Lumbering Falls and Forest, but leaves them with still Devoted Druid. But it does also put something gigantic into play. So I don't think I would take just Through the Breach, but I would take Through the Breach alongside something else. Like, if they give me Through the Breach priority, I'll take it. All right, well, I'll take the pile that those three have. Draw. Can we find an Emrakul here? Is that too much to ask for? Bottom. Do I want a Dak Faden? Don't know that I do. I think I can do better. I have so many cantrips and whatnot. Okay. Let's go. Let's crack my fetch. Now I'm going to take less damage and I'm not that worried about Let's go Through the Breach. Woodfall Primus. Blow up your Lumbering Falls. Yeah, they don't have enough mana to activate it. Hit. Come back. Sadly can't kill Corsair. Let's just kill your blue here. And now they drew Edric. Unfortunately, they drew a land off top. But oh no, Sword of Temptation. Oh jeez. Okay. So I had to draw something pretty good here. I saw a lot of cards with that Factor Fiction, and I did not see a lot of action. Alright, let's play Nahiri. Let's discard Mountain. Venser. Oh, Venser's kind of interesting. Okay, so now they have an Ancestral on top, so they're going to play the land. They have Edric. And now I think I have Venser Beginning of Combat, because I can Venser the Sower of Temptation. They can't recast Sower. And then I get my Woodfall Primus back, so they can't attack. And then now I have a couple more draws to find something. All right, let's kick things off with Faithless Looting. Okay, Inferno Titan will do the trick. I mean, it doesn't win me the game, but I think it puts me in a pretty good spot. Inferno Titan. Kill Edric and do a point to you. Is that right? Yeah, that's probably good. And then plus Nahiri and pass the turn. And now, next turn, I can Emrakul them. So they have Ancestral and Sower in hand. And they can Sower Inferno Titan, but then I still have two blockers, so they can't hit Nahiri. And next turn, they know I have Emrakul, so they know Nahiri's dub. So they drew Craterhoof. But they don't have enough to cast Craterhoof, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Even if they play a land 7. Okay, so they already revealed Den Protector. So they have Denny P in hand. Am I going to come back and win this game? I think I am. Because we know their hand is Sower of Temptation, Island. Oh, I guess they go to 16. So they don't quite die, so they're going to get to Sower my Inferno Titan. Okay, so I need something else here. Well, is that true? They have to sack 6 things. And then Sower has to block... Oh, Sower doesn't have to block Emrakul, I guess, is the joke. Yeah, the Corsair, them getting a life off Corsair actually might be enough. Okay, so they have... Well, let's see what we can draw here. Time Walk will almost assuredly do it. Let's see. So if I Emrakul them, they sack six lands. Oh, this is interesting. I could Time Walk plus Nahiri, and then let's see. They're at 15. No, Time Walk doesn't necessarily do it. Let's see. What do we do here? This is actually kind of close. So if we just Nahiri, this comes back. Emrakul comes back to my hand. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I don't actually reshuffle, and I still have Faithless Looting. If I go Nahiri, attack with Emrakul, they sack all their lands, they go to 1. And then next turn, then I Time Walk, and then I Looting, and I have Emrakul in hand. I can't find Through the Breach. I didn't actually reshuffle because Emrakul never died. If I plus Nahiri and Time Walk, yeah, this... I think we're just going to do this. Let's see, what else can we... What's in our deck? Fractured Identity is the other card. All right, so we're just going to get a bunch of looks at a Fractured Identity, basically. I think that's the whole joke. Okay. And if we find Fractured Identity, we can just Fractured Identity Inferno Titan, and then they die. Because they're not going to sack Sora. They're just going to sack all their lands, yeah. Then they're going to go to 1. And I think I just Time Walk first, untap, this comes back. Remand doesn't do much for me. Let's go Faithless Looting. Oh, hold on. Faithless Looting. Oh, then I get to discard Emrakul and Remand. Get to reshuffle with Emrakul. And now let's brainstorm. I found the Fracture Identity, but I didn't find the land. Cute. I'm at 4. So I'm just dead if this happens. I guess we'll put back these two. Then we're going to ponder, look for Time Walk. We have outs. There's the land, sure. That lands that would have... The island that would have... Let me win with Fracture Identity. I would like to shuffle Time Walk. Nope. Close, but no cigar. That was a good match. Let's jump back in the queue. We're not done yet. Alrighty, welcome to round two. Lost a nail-biter round one against a very strong deck. Even the Fire Ice on the 2/1 toughness creatures on turn two was not enough to let me get there. Unfortunately, this hand is fine. I mean, it doesn't have colors other than blue, but I get to ponder into or preordain into blue for deck, and then could get some of these powerful things going. Yeah, our last opponent's deck. I'm still thinking about that match, especially since my opponent's just chilling here. It's definitely better. I mean, they had Ancestral Time Vault Mana or Ancestral Mox Ruby Mana Crypt, but I think our deck is very good. And We're a mana short or a life point short of defeating them. Because if they're at 1 fewer life, they would have had to block with Sower and we would have got Inferno Titan back. Alright, mono green, huh? Just play Needle Spires on 1. Fixes all my colors nicely. It also means that if I draw Fire Ice on turn 2, I can just cast that. Red it and preordaining on 1. And if I miss on turn 2, I can just preordain turn 2. Oh, can I just get a Fire Ice? Is that too much to ask for? Let's see. I don't want Woodfall Primus in this spot. Remand is probably... No, Remand is actually just not good enough here. The reason is they just have access to so much mana, and then next turn I might have to tap out for DAC anyway, that I think leaving up Remand doesn't seem particularly fruitful. Okay. They don't have another land, apparently, or at least not another forest. Or maybe they do? Who knows? As things currently stand, they have access to 5 mana, which is a substantial amount. They were to play Tireless Tracker before playing their forest. Got it. Into another elf. Jeez. Jeez. They are just going off, huh? I'm just going to play Dak, even though I know Dak's going to die. I could steal their clue. That doesn't seem quite good enough. Let's just draw two and then discard two and then get run over, I'm sure. Don't really want Mana Confluence or Steam Vents. This looks like a good plan. They can sack Elder end of turn to get another clue. Wow, their draw was pretty good. Also, my dog is going nuts. They did not sack Elder. Interesting. Huh. I guess I don't get that, but we'll see what transpires. They could have killed Dak by pumping the Tireless Tracker, but maybe they want to spend their mana on something else. 3, 5, Memory Jar. Okay. Fire Ice is a little bit late to the party, but might actually still be worth casting. Like, killing Raphelos and a bird means that, dear Lord Dog, what is going on over there? Means that their Memory Jar gets just so much worse. And then they get to sack their clue, draw their card. Tireless Tracker gets a little bit buffer. I think they really want to sack that Elder earlier, because that's an extra forest with Raphelos. They could have just sacked that extra clue. Basically, they'd be in a pretty similar spot, but have extra value up. Okay, there's a swamp. I mean, if they go, depending on what they do, we could also maybe just land a big Fractured Identity or something like that. Plow Under? Yeah, that's gross. That I would have conceded to that earlier, but we're actually in a spot here where we're not just dead to Plow Under. Though discarding the Mana Confluence now has come back to bite me, because I can't Nahiri that Tireless Tracker, which is what I would otherwise do. I'm just going to pass. And my plan is to cast a Vincer. Kind of hope they crack Jar here. I mean, if they don't have anything else to do, they might want to just crack Jar. Now it feels weird that the dog isn't barking. I got used to it. They're just going to pass. All right. Interesting. Not sure what their plan is, because they're not going to crack Jar now, because you wouldn't want to tap the Elvish Mystic before cracking the Jar. Oh, never mind. There we go. And then they're Unburial Rites-ing Raphelos. Okay. I guess I'll Vincer that. Sure. I'm not, like, thrilled about this, but I think that's better than letting them have Raphelos. And then now I can play my Needle Spires and pass the turn. And we'll see what they're up to here. Alright, let's see. They're going to ascend with Tireless Tracker and Elvish Mystic. No, probably not the Elvish Mystic. I guess I'll take it again. I mean, at some point I might want to block this Tireless Tracker. I don't think now is the time. Are they going to crack this Jar or what? What's going on over here? Or are they just going to Unburial Rites again? Looks like Unburial Rites is the plan. Oh, Finale of Devastation. Okay, so they're going to get Raphelos with that instead. Sure. Fractured Identity. Let's just go Nahiri. The reason I want to do that is I need to deal with this Tireless Tracker at some point. And Nahiri seems like a good enough way to do that. It also exiles it, so they can't get it back with their Unburial Rites, which I know they have. And I have now Vincer to block it. I mean, it's kind of weird. Like, my opponent had like 10 mana when I had 2, and they at some point landed a Plow Under. But I'm not sure exactly why, but it doesn't feel like my opponent's doing much. They just weren't very aggressive with sacking Elder. They haven't cracked Jar yet. I guess they just wanted to crack Jar when they had a Raphelos in play, but, well, I mean, I don't know. I just haven't For how dead I felt, it doesn't seem like I'm just dead here. Also, Fracture Identity is a pretty good last card to have in hand. Well, Strip Mine's annoying, sure. I mean, you got... Do you what? Four, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 11 mana now. You just gotta crack the jar if your hand is just unbearable, right? Or not, I mean, who knows? You're all floated blue, sure. Might as well make them go to their second main phase if they want to get full jar advantage. Finale Devastation. I'm not sure about this card. Doesn't seem quite good enough for me, but who knows. Let's see. What is their plan now? Okay, so they're doing stuff. This does not look like Umbrella. It's, oh, natural order. I even floated the blue. I don't know what they're natural ordering for, but it can't be good for me. Yeah, that will do it. That will do it indeed. 11 points minus 2. Alright. Well, we're dying to mono greens again. Let's see. Yeah, I didn't change anything last time, and it worked out perfectly. So, I mean, maybe I want Sower, actually, given that they have, like, a bunch of Unburial Rites type of things. I still don't know what to cut, though. It feels like my deck is kind of set up the way I want it to be. Yeah, I kind of don't like it. All right, well, I would like to play first. Yeah, this hand's good. We get to still probably lead with Needle Spires. Figure I might as well play my tap land first, though. Needle Spires is a lot worse than a non-tap land last game. Sol Ring? Alright, well, here I actually think I go Preordain, because this ups the chances that I have Dak on 3. Alright, I'll put Emrakul on the bottom. I'll put Remand on top, because if I don't draw anything else, my plan is to go Fumarole and leave up Remand next turn. Sure. Why not turn 2 Garrick? And there's a Tree Speaker. Alright, Fumarole go. I'm really hoping this Bribery lands nicely. Or I draw Through the Breach and just Through the Breach Inferno Titan. Let's see. What am I going to do here? I guess I'm remanding whatever they cast. They have, because they have access now to 3-5 mana without even playing a land. 6 mana with a land. Okay, I guess Scourge Elder's fine. And are they going to start by making beasts? Beastarinos? Nope, they're untapping lands, which I don't know what's better or worse for me. Survival of the Fittest, sure. There's just no point in remanding a 2 mana spell. It's just not effective. And pass. Yeah, let's brainstorm first in case we draw fetch land. There's Fire Ace and there's Through the Breach. Okay, what do I not want here? Dig Through Time is bad. And then actually kind of doesn't matter on the rest because I'm going to see all of it. I could fire the Tree Speaker, but that doesn't seem good because they already have access to 5, 6, 7, 8 mana without the Tree Speaker, so... I think this is good, and then next turn I might be able to like Through the Breach Inferno Titan to wipe out all their stuff. Or just Bribery them, depending on what I think is worth doing. So they're gonna Survival here. Discarding Sundering Titan, there's something better than Sundering Titan. That's kind of frightening. I guess Craterhoof might just be a win, which is why you would do that, but... They got Tireless Tracker, okay. I mean, I guess that's fine. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna Through the Breach Inferno Titan and let the chips fall where they may. Because I can go kill your Tireless Tracker on the trigger, attack, kill your Tree Speaker, Sakura Tribe Elder, and then hit Garrick. I mean, it depends what they do with the Garrick. Maybe if they make a beast, that might be a little bit worse. But also, if I don't have to use Remand this turn, I might end up in a spot where I can, like, fire down a Tree Speaker or Maybe Tireless Tracker, depending on how they tap their mana. Okay. 3 mana. They still have access to 7 mana, and they haven't played a land yet. It's pretty wild. They have one card in hand? Okay. I mean, I kind of assume it's a land. I guess it doesn't have to be, because they have Sakura Tribelder to trigger the Tireless Tracker, but I don't even know. No plays. Okay, they're going to make a beast. Now, I think I ice the beast. Yeah, they can only make one. I guess I just have to leave them with a beast. Or, wait, I can fire Garrick and Sakura Tribelder. No, I'm going to throw the Breach Inferno Titan. I think that's just going to be the best. The question is, how do I want to manage it? If I ice the beast, I can attack Garrick with the Inferno Titan, which does, like, that just wipes everything but the beast out, and they end up with 6 mana, 7 mana off Tireless Tracker. Yeah, I guess that's fine. I can't quite do everything I want to do. It would be nice to be able to fire something, but I think this will be okay. I just want to get my opponent's board a lot more clear. All right, and then I'm going to do 3 damage to Tireless Tracker. Oh, wait. Oh, no, this is fine. Because they can make Tireless Tracker a 4-4 here. But if they do that, then I get an attack and then Inferno Titan it again. And they've sacked their Sakura Tribelder, so it no longer... I no longer have to kill the Scourge Tribelder. Yeah. No, this is good. For a second, I thought I miscalculated. But then I realized I would never miscalculate. That's not true. If you watch my videos, I do it all the time. All right, so now they do that. Draw. Deals 3. Tech. Garrick Wildspeaker. And then I do 1 and 2. Kill those things. All right. I mean... It's not that we've completely solved things, but I think we're in more reasonable shape. They've drawn a couple cards off their clues, but they don't have enough mana to... I guess they could crater hoof me by playing a land here. But it wouldn't be lethal. It'd be, what, 10, 12 damage? And I get to bribery them next turn. Well, if they have Plow Under, I don't. But if they have Plow Under... Actually, Plow Under's kind of brutal because I have to put 2 tap lands back. But then I can keep up Dig Through Time or Remand, and that's still decent, too. My legacy cube deck is battling against these vintage cube decks, and I think putting up a fight, but yeah, we're still things are not being easy. Just them starting with, like, Sol Ring versus me just playing one land per turn. I mean, that's just rough. Okay, Natural Order. This is where I hope they don't have Progenitus. Terastodon. Terastodon's annoying. Yeah, I actually don't feel like I'm in completely hopeless shape. Okay, land is pretty good, because now I can leave up Remand and Dig Through Time. And or Foft if they don't do anything. Memory Jar. Kind of like Remand, because Memory Jar could mess up my bribery here. Ooh, Time Walk's interesting. Do I care about blocking? So if I get Crater Hoof, +3/+3, so it's 6, 12, 20 damage. They'd have to chump, but then I would die. Let's actually crack Strand. I think we get Tundra here, and then I'm going to cast Dig Through Time. Kind of, it does matter a little bit what I exile, because I have Emrakul to potentially shuffle. Ooh, Soulfire Grandmaster and Time Walk is eventually with, oh, Fractured Identity. Let's get land and Fractured Identity. And then we're going to go ahead and block. untap, play a land. Let's go Fractured Identity or Terastodon. Oh yeah, this is good. I mean, if they have something, I guess they could get me. Let's go Island and Sol Ring. I don't want to give them too many tokens, and then pass, and then now I can bribery them for Craterhoof, and they can't really make use of Jar all that well because they won't have that much mana left if they want to crack the Jar this turn. Okay, I think we're actually back into it here, because Craterhoof on this board has got to be lethal, right? I have 18 plus Craterhoof is 23 plus 4 times 4, so it's 39. Yeah, that sounds lethal to me. Didn't even need the Time Walk, though. The Time Walk could also work. Obviously, if they have like a Strip Mine or something, that delays it. But with Time Walk, I'm feeling pretty good about it still. They have two cards in hand. Jar and X. I guess they're going to play the Jar and pass the turn. And then now I'm going to bribery them. If they want to crack Jar in response, they can, but that kills their Jar, and I still probably get something. Oh no, they have Craterhoof in hand. 4, 6, 7, 8. Okay. Well, that's unfortunate. That makes me less happy. Let's get Deranged Hermit. So Craterhoof right now. If they Craterhoof right now, they get to... They have three things in play, so it's 11 plus 9, so it's 20 damage. Okay. So, yeah, let's just get Deranged Hermit then. And then let's make some attacks. So they can't even play an elf if they play Craterhoof next turn, right? And I have 9, so that's 6 plus 12 plus 8. Yeah, this works out then. Because if they take 18 here, then next turn, then they're... I mean, they don't even know I have the Time Walk, but they're pretty close to being dead here. All right, so they're just going to take 18. They can Craterhoof here, but that's not going to be enough. And then I think that being able to Time Walk next turn is going to let me deliver lethal, if I don't even have lethal in play already. Wow, they're pretty close on the Craterhoof, huh? Let's see. Now they're back in the tank. All right, they're going to Jar because they can't actually win if they don't. These cards all do nothing. So, given that I have Time Walk in hand, it seems likely that they're going to end up perishing. Okay, they can Strip Mine my Tundra. They can play some creatures, but even with the Hermit being gone, it feels like they're not going to be able to survive this. I guess they could Assassin's Trophy or something. All right, they're gonna pass. We're gonna discard. Discard into Craterhoof, and I guess I will not pay because I don't have the option. Okay, send all the clowns in. So are they dead right now? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2. Yeah, they're dead right now. Oh no, they're not. Sorry, these are 2 1-1s. They're gonna block the 3 big ones and go to 2. Oh, I guess they'll block 2 big ones and go to 1. No, they have to block Terastodon and Elfin, assuming they don't have a removal spell, which hopefully they don't. Oh, they just blocked incorrectly to die. That also works. I was going to Time Walk anyway, but I guess I'll take it. Do I want Arcane Artisan? They don't have actually that many ways to kill Arcane Artisan, so it might actually be good just to play on 3 and then maybe take out Jace, Architect of Thought. Though I guess that is good. Jace is good against a Ranged Hermit. It's possible Soulfire Grandmaster is just too slow. Could definitely see that. It's a 6 mana kill with Time Walk. That's not that much to ask. I wonder if maybe Sower is good. Maybe I'll just put in those two and run this instead. All right. No Sol Ring, just one time. That seems like not too much to ask, I think. Let's see what my opponent has going. All right, my opponent will look to six. I'm going to keep, you know, library on the draw is obviously powerful, but I just don't worry that if they start with Soul Ring or an Elf or something, ooh, which they did not, it might be too slow, but I'm going to run it. This is where I would love, like, anything cheap. All right. Faceless Looting doesn't really count. All right, they're going to get to Rafelis. Remand would actually be good here. I think I just play Needle Spires. I just need to get red mana going. And I'm going to discard. I think I'm going to discard Faithless Looting. I mean, it's that or Island. They're both pretty close, I guess. Come on, just don't get Plow Undered. That is all I ask. Okay, Tireless Tracker. Get their card back, yeah. I need... Oh, Time Walk helps. Time Walk helps a lot. That's basically an Explorer, which... It's kind of all I want. All right, let's go Time Walk. Draw, which is really just looting because I'm going to have to discard. Now I can discard an island. Untap. Deck Faden. No, that doesn't do much for me. I think I'm going to Preordain here. Because my plan is to go Preordain and leave Remand up. Bottom. Yeah, it's bottom both the lands, I think. Play a land, pass. And now I get to library plus remand and then look for either Through the Breach or bribery as action to play next turn. And then I also have Venser, which I could do something like Venser the Rafelis on my main phase to just make it so my opponent can't play anything big. Time Walk helps. Oh, I do have a piece of power. I have a Time Walk. Yeah, what am I complaining about Legacy? Psh. That's just me whining. Oracle of Moldiah. I've already played a land. All right. Oh, there's a Crater Hoof. How's it going, big guy? And they're going to crack their clue. I'm going to library in response here. Because if I draw fire, I'm just... Probably gonna kill something, though I probably would still just kill Rafelis. Okay, and they draw birds, so they have Crater Hoof in hand. And they can even crack their clue here. Yeah, this is all pretty good. Draw a bird, and their top card's Overgrown Tomb, so I know they have Crater Hoof in hand. And I didn't draw anything all that good. And Remand was just ineffective against all the things they had. Okay. So if I vent, so they have 5, 6. If I hit two lands, they can Crater Hoof me, so I can't even Venser Rafelis. I can't even Venser Crater Hoof, right? 6, 12. Wow, this is insane. Not being able, drawing all these cards and not being able to kill Rafelis is pretty rough. So if I Venser Rafelis and they hit two lands, we easily kill with Crater Hoof. But right now they have 12, 13. I guess if they hit two lands, they still can't. Yeah, I guess this is still better for me. All right, discard a mana confluence. I just have to try to counter Crater Hoof or Venser Crater Hoof and then Inferno Titan. And I still think Crater Hoof actually kills me. This is wild. I really need to draw Through the Breach or I don't know, bribery doesn't even really do it. Yeah. Maybe I needed to decide in Mizzium Mortars. Maybe it was kind of crazy not to, I don't know. Alright, so they're drawing their Assassin's Trophy. Top card is their Soul Ring. Still have Overgrown Tomb, Assassin's Trophy, Crater Hoof in hand. Oracle of Moldiah, Tireless Tracker is a pretty pretty filthy combination here. I'm just doing nothing. I have actually played one spell so far. No, I've played two spells. A Time Walk and a Preordain. That's all I've done so far. Which is not the most awe-inspiring. Okay, so they're not hoofing me this turn. And they know about Venser, right? Yeah, they... I don't even remember if they do or not. but they're respecting it by not attacking with Oracle. I could bounce Rafelos and block Tireless Tracker. And then they can replay Rafelos, but they can't play anything else. I'm going to draw a card and see what we see here. Okay, well, Through the Breach is interesting. Yeah, I think we Vincer Rafelos here. I could also... No, Through the Breach... Because through the Breach, Emrakul doesn't even do the trick, so... I could also just Vincer Tireless Tracker. It's possible that that's what I want to do. Because if I Vincer Tireless Tracker, they get to replay Tracker and it doesn't do much. They have Assassin's... Oh, they have Assassin's Trophy in hand. So I'm not even going to get to attack with this Inferno Titan. So Through the Breaching is actually not as good as just casting it. I think we're actually just going to bounce the Tireless Tracker. It's such a play of weakness, but I don't really think I have too many other options. And, alright, they're letting that get bounced. Hopefully they just like use Assassin's Trophy on like my library or something. Not that I think they're very likely to do that, but... One can hope. One can dream. And I can't even kill Rafelos plus Tireless Tracker with Inferno Titan. Because they have that clue sitting there. I do not like the spot I'm in. Alright, there goes Tireless Tracker. I'm sure I'm going to get Terastodon or something here. Alright, there goes the clue. Finale of Devastation. There we go, Soaring. And yeah, we're just mega dead. Yeah, letting an unchecked Rafelos sit there was just more powerful than Library, which was kind of my fear with the Library after all was said and done. Yeah. I mean, I'm aware that Natural Order is going to get me, but I couldn't beat a hand of Natural Order Crater Hoof when they had that much mana anyway. So I basically had to plan for the worst case or best case scenario. Yeah, they're going to kill all my lands. And they still have Assassin's Trophy and Crater Hoof in hand. And even if I kill Rafelos, they still have enough mana to do all the things. And I don't have anything close. Yeah, we're dead. Alright, this was a sick deck and we got destroyed. But the good news... That means more cube drafts in the future. Thanks for watching, and next time we'll try and pick up a few more wins.